Hello all, my name is Charak and now I'm standing in Kamlonga, Lake Road, Osaka, Florida, Texilla American University. We are here to look at the facilities what Texilla American University is offering, including the labs, libraries, and also we can meet with students and employees out there. You might be wondering where we are actually standing. So as I said, it's in Lake Road, just near Choppy Supermarket. Kamlonga. So come on, let's look into the facilities what Texilla is offering inside. Let's walk in.
Hello, my name is Sean. How are you?
Good, thank you. How are you?
I'm doing good. He's one of our students at Texilla American University. So let him talk a few things about the university. What facilities are you getting inside?
Hello, my name is Manasseh David Sampa. I am a student here at American Texilla University. It's an amazing school. Features, the facilities are amazing, state of the art. I am a student doing business administration, 4-year program, and so far in first year, it's amazing. You will not regret coming here. You will be amazed by the facilities and the care that they give our students. It's a good place to be at.
Thank you so much for your feedback.
Thank you. I'm going to Chopi right now to have my breakfast.
That's my advantage
of
being here.
Thank you. So let's get inside, and I hope you heard what about the facilities what we are offering from Texilla American University. It's fantastic, isn't it? Let's get inside the reception and see what we have there.
All right, now we are standing in front of Texilla American University Zambia's reception. Let's see what they have got. Hello, Ms. Finn. How are you?
Fine.
Okay. So we are taking a live video over here to see the facilities what Texilla American University has to offer. Can you just give us a brief description about the lobby and the reception, what you actually do?
So welcome to Texilla.
Thank you.
So I'll show you through. This is our sitting area where the walk-in visitors come and take a seat while they're waiting to be attended to by different people and departments. So we've got the TV here. We put our programs, videos showing what programs we're offering, running different faculties and courses. Then we've got the students' affairs room where students can get to the individuals of student affairs issues. And we've got the notice board there. The notice board will put our information on a daily basis, depending on what information is needed.
Okay.
Then Mr.
Sharut
will take it through and show you other
different. Alright. Okay, come on. Let's see our other facilities, what we have to see in terms of the classrooms. So this is the classroom number one. It's named as, okay. Let's see what facilities they have got. Oh, wow. This looks amazing. Okay. It's completely an air-conditioned classroom with a CCTV camera, of course, to watch the students. And of course, the projector. I think, great. They don't follow a traditional way of teaching. Texilla American University follows the modern way of teaching. They have a very good projector and a very huge board in terms of the facilities what they're offering. It looks fantastic, and the modern way of classroom. And students are, of course, going to enjoy learning with Texilla. Okay, let's check one of the facilities what Texilla has. Oh, this is amazing. They said that this is actually imported from different parts of the world and so many other things, including the labs and the books. This is pretty comfortable for the students. Very, very comfortable. Thank you, Texilla, for this. We are out of the classroom, and that was an amazing experience seeing the modern facilities. Here we have the reading room. Okay, let's get inside. I think all the students are busy with the classes, so I don't find anyone in the reading room, but this looks pretty amazing with the seating facilities, and anyone can connect their laptops here because they have the wiring facilities, I believe. Yes, they have all the cable wiring facilities with the internet as well. And one thing you should know, that Texilla American University campus is completely a free Wi-Fi zone area, so all the students who are studying with us gets free Wi-Fi. And they don't have to worry about internet because they have their own laptops and desktops where they can learn. It's not mandated that they have to go to a library to collect the books. I think previously I saw a few students sitting here with the laptops and learning. Okay, that's great, amazing. So let's go to the next classroom or next facility what Texila has. So we saw the classroom, we saw the reading room, and we are taking a walk towards. I think there are a few students sitting here. Let's see what they have. Hello. How are you?
Fine.
Did they disturb you or you can study?
No.
All right. Where are the other students, your colleagues?
Jockeys.
Jockeys. Okay. Might be break time.
Yes, it's break time.
Okay. What is your name?
Ishan.
Ishan.
Yes.
Great. What are you studying actually with Texila?
Medicine.
You're studying your Health Professional Foundation program?
Yes.
Okay. When did you start?
In April.
In April?
Yes.
So how was your experience being with Texila so many months?
It's fine. I'm enjoying it here.
You're enjoying it? You got friends?
Yes.
Great. Okay. And what else facilities they have for you? Like, who's your favorite teacher or your faculty who's here?
Favorite teacher? Mr. Anthony.
Okay.
Yeah.
Looks like you have a huge list and you're thinking who's your favorite teacher.
That's probably my name.
Alright. So, did you see our labs and our facilities? How's it? Did you like it? Or?
Yeah, they love it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's great. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Great. So you didn't go to Chalkies?
No.
Okay. You're not hungry?
No.
Okay. Maybe there's one more student who's sitting there. We can talk to her. How are you? Okay, I'm doing good. So what's your name?
Mogami.
Okay, so you also went to Health Professional Foundation program?
Yes.
So how was it so far?
It's okay.
It's okay?
Fine.
You got some friends?
Yes.
Okay, so how was the teaching facilities what we have at Texila?
They're fine.
Mm-hmm.
They're very much okay.
You like the infrastructure?
Mm-hmm.
So might be, I think you were seated with your parents over here, you saw the facilities beforehand, right?
Yes.
Great, that's another feedback about Texila. You can see the projectors on when compared to the other classrooms. You can see the projectors on and you can see the facilities what Texila is actually offering. So let's move on to the next classroom. Okay, so now we are in the long corridor of Texila American University where we have the other classrooms here. And I think all the students are on break. Might be the next time we can meet more students. Let's move on to the computer lab. So we saw the classrooms, as I was saying, like all students are on break. I can see Dean for Business, IT and Education. Excuse me, ma'am, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you, sir?
I'm doing good. So we are taking a video about Texila facilities available.
Okay.
So I would like you to share a few words about Texila American University,
Zambia. Welcome to Texila American University, Zambia. Bringing education to life, that is our theme motto. And I am the dean for the School of Business, Information Technology and Education. We are giving world-class education in the field of business, IT and education. We are offering full-time, part-time and even distance and blended mode of education we are giving. Students who are enrolled in the distance mode, they can come and attend the residential class we are planning in the month of August. And we are having wonderful infrastructures in terms of lab, computer lab, and we are also providing the medical school with all the labs.
Thank you so much to Dean. So let's move out of the Dean's office and let's get and see what they have in the computer lab for the students from Texila American University. I think that's classroom. We have the computer lab out here. Come on, let's see what facilities they are offering.
Okay.
Alright, oh, so many computers for the students, and I think they're expecting a huge count of students over here because we have all the facilities for each and every individual. Any classroom can sit here and do their projects, assignments, or anything like that. They have some high quality computers available here with a good seating facility as well. So, you have seen the computer lab and the facilities what they have. And you should be wondering why Texila is having such a huge computer lab and what is about the modern teaching technology what we have. It's pretty simple. Texila American University gives LMS, that is Learning Management System, access to all the students including distance and online programs and also full-time programs. So they have a individual username and password, which they can use, and they have a digital library in that. Also, all the facilities like the teaching materials and everything is available in their LMS. So it's not mandatory for a student to depend on the faculties, or it's not mandatory for them to come to campus. They can use their LMS and do the education. They also have faculty interaction in their LMS. So LMS is a huge topic, you know. You start talking, it just goes on. Anyways, so let's go to the labs and libraries and see the facilities on the first floor.
Okay, so we are going towards the first floor of Texas American University Zambia campus, seeing the facilities in terms of labs and libraries, as I told you earlier. So let's see the facilities, come on.
So now we are entering Texas American University Zambia campus's library, and let's see what facilities they are offering inside the library and what books they have. Hello, good morning, how are you?
Good, thanks, how are you?
I'm doing good. So we are taking a video about Texas American University's library and other facilities what we are offering. So maybe you can give us a brief explanation about the books and from where the books are coming, etc.
Okay, currently we have books in business administration, HPFP, IT, and as well as the medicine books. And in total, we have about 550 books, and these books are purchased all over the world, inclusive Zambia.
Okay, that's great. So you said the books are from different parts of the world.
Yes.
So is it helpful for all the students and faculties who are here?
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Because these books are going from different parts of the world, and I think it exposes people to say we can get books from everywhere, and the information is not limited, mm-hmm. because it's not just coming from one part of a country.
That sounds fantastic, isn't it?
Yes.
I think you also have some sitting facilities with the computer for the students. What are those for?
Okay, yeah, these are computers where students can come in and do their research. On these computers, we've got the websites of our e-journals.
Okay.
Yes, so students can come here and access e-journals. Yes.
That's an amazing feature. Wow, that's great. That's an well-equipped library you have seen over here with, as I said, Texas American University with state-of-art infrastructure. So let's move on to the lab facilities what Texas is offering. So now we are heading outside the library, and this is a fine way to the laboratories. We have around 4 labs. As I was always repeating, you know, Texas American University have the lab equipments from different parts of the world, and one of the best lab equipments which we can get, because we have campuses across Zambia and UAE, and this is the third campus what we have started in Lusaka in Zambia. So as I'm standing in front of physics and physiology lab. I can find the dean for medicine inside. Let's get introduced to him. Please come inside. Hello sir, how are you?
Yes, fine.
Great sir. So we are taking a video about the facilities about Texas American University. Yeah. So he is Dr. Vetrivedan, who is from India, who is our dean for medicine. So he'll be like showing around the facilities what we have for the students in this particular lab.
And this is a name is called physiology lab. In this physiology lab, we are doing the investigations of the hematology related investigations. So we are doing the total blood count and differential count and RBC count, red blood count, platelet count and absolute eosinophil count. We are having the instruments of binocular microscopes are there. We are having the binocular microscopes and blood pressure apparatus and hemocytometer. It contains the RBC pipette, then WBC pipette, another thing. This is a WBC pipette and Nabor counting chamber for counting of the cells. And before doing the experiment, the patients, we can do the blood pressure from the patients. An examination by the use of this stethoscope and temperature also, we can take the temperature also. We can take the temperature. And this is the hemocytometer. From this, we can do the differential count. We can do the differential count, we can do it. So this is the instrument. We can use the different types of cells here. Eosinophils, neutrophils, basophils or different cells of count, we can count. Finally, we are counting the nearly about the 100 cells. We are counting the 100 cells, namely called neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils. Finally, we count the how many cells are coming in the differential count. So, we are containing the centrifuge. This is the instrument called centrifuge. This is used for to separate the blood from the plasma or serum. Separate the blood or plasma. And we are doing the many separation and distillation of the fluids. This is a reagent bottle. This is a stethoscope and this is a first aid box. This is a treadmill. In the treadmill we are doing the we can assess the heart activity and functions and the activity. Electrocardiogram is taken during this treadmill machine. First the patient is asked to go down in the slow speed. Then after increase of the speed, we are connecting this treadmill to the ECG monitor. Then we can take the ECG. So the normal ECG and ECG should be taken in the stress. At the we can assess the heart functions.
That's great.
Yes. And this is the refrigerator. We can use the reagents and chemicals.
Okay.
Yes. The temperature is 2 to 8 degree centigrade.
Okay.
This is a small refrigerator. These also keep the reagents and chemicals.
Mm-hmm.
This is a hot air oven. This is a hot air oven. It is for to sterilize. We are using the steam heat. Extreme steam heat to sterilize the surgical instruments. Surgical instruments and glassware which withstands the high temperatures.
Okay.
And these are the Bunsen burner for heating the solutions and doing the blood investigations and urine examinations. These are the gas points are available. And water facilities are available for washing the glasses. This is the microscopic hematocrit centrifuge. This microhematocrit centrifuge, we can use it for the blood investigations, separation of fluids and PCV, packed cell volume, we are doing here. This is the physical balance. From 0 to 220 gram, we can measure this balance. These are the measuring jars. These are the measuring jars for the investigation up to 25 ml. This is a 50 ml. This is a 100 ml. This is a 20 ml capacity.
And how many students you think we can accommodate in the class?
Yes, we are having to accommodate at least each table two students.
Okay.
Each students.
All right.
At present, we can accommodate 42.
Right? 42 students. So that's amazing. When there are universities where we don't have labs, Texela American University Zambia has its own laboratory where you can accommodate around 40 to 50 students on an average. So, how do you think the facility when compared to other universities according to you?
Sir, really, it's great. The Texela American University provides very good education. This physiology lab, we can do all the hematological investigations, including blood investigation, total WBC count, total RBC count, platelet count, absolute eosinophil count. We are having the instruments, including the binocular microscope for every student, and all the grades of the glass vessels are there. Each GP apparatus and stethoscopes and thermometers are there, and blood pressure monitors and microscopic slides and color reagents, bottles and microcentrifuge and balance, and there is a distilling of water, and every facilities are available. All for to the, we want to make a very good student from the Texela American University in the School of Medicine.
Great, sir. So I also came to know, I have a doubt.
whenever a student is doing seeing into this microscopic thing, they said that you are able to view through the projector in that main screen.
Yes, possible.
You have this facility.
Yes, possible. Yes.
Okay, that's great.
Yes.
So you can know that, you know, like even each and every lab, they have a projector and a computer facility, which any student will be learning with Texas American University. So let's move on to the next lab with our own dean, who can explain the other lab as well. Alright, so we are getting inside biology and microbiology lab at Texas American University, Zambia. Let's get help of Dr. Vetriveeran to get a detailed idea about the lab. So please help us with the facilities what you are having in this particular lab.
Yes, this microbiology lab is well equipped, all instruments available for doing the microbiological investigations for to attend the microbiological sections in the Texas American University. We are doing the general microbiology here and immunology, bacteriology and virology, parasitology, mycology and applied microbiology. So all we are covering in the practical sections. The practical sections we are having the binocular microscopes and graded variety of glass measurements. This is a glass measurement. It's a measuring jars and cylinders, microscopes, this is instrument is called it is a pressure stream sterilizer, it is an autoclave. This autoclave is the machine, is a steam machine. We can use it for the sterilize the surgical instruments. We can sterilize the surgical instruments and glassware and liquids and solids, linens and surgical instruments, culture medias, everything we can sterilize. We can use the temperature of 121 degree for about 15 to 30 minutes depending upon the content of the storage at the time of autoclave. So the instrument is very good, useful for to sterilizing the solids and liquids and handle instruments and culture media, surgical instruments, everything we can use it in this instrument. So even every students we are providing the binocular microscope. So here we are doing the gram staining, acid phos staining and stool examination, bacterial culture and fungal culture and spotters of the microbiological pictures. So the microbiology is a study of microorganisms. Microbiology is a study of microorganism in the help of the microscopes.
Okay.
So we can use the bacteria, virus and fungi in this binocular microscopes. So the each students we are providing the binocular microscopes. We can cut the slide here, we can focus the slide and see it in the microscope. We can identify the gram-positive cocci, gram-positive bacilli and viruses, fungi, bacterial examination and microbiological examination, stool examination, everything we can focus here and we can connect to the LCD projector to the board.
Okay, so it means that that's again another modern technology what Texas American University has. So this is all about biology and microbiology lab.
Yes.
All right. So I would like to disturb you to another lab which we have, because we have another two more labs which we have to see.
Yes.
Okay, let's move on to the next lab.
Yes.
What Texas American University is having.
Yes.
Please come. All right. For those who are watching, we are now in front of Human Anatomy Lab. Here we have Dr. Vetriveeran who is going to support us and tell us more about the lab. So it's particularly like for the students to know about the human body and other things. But yeah, let's get to know what it is all about. Please come. Okay, so we have Dr. Satish over here. Hello, Dr. Satish. How are you?
Fine. How are you?
I'm doing good. So we are taking a video just showing the facilities about Texas American University, Zambia. So he's one of our faculty with Texas American University, Zambia. He's basically from India. So can you just show around the lab what facilities Texela is offering for the students?
Okay, so welcome to the Human Anatomy Lab for the medical program offered by ETAU Zambia. So in this particular lab, the medical students in their first year will be undergoing the practicals related to human anatomy. So we have the complete set of human anatomical models available in our laboratory. And as per the recommendations of the Health Professional Council of Zambia, whatever is the models which has to be there, every single model is available in this particular laboratory. The anatomical structure of the human arm.
Okay.
So the student used to have a clear picture of what are the different parts of an upper arm of the human body.
Mm-hmm.
Likewise, you have the complete body, including the thoracic cavity. So the student can find out what are the different anatomical regions present in the upper part of the human body.
I think that is the foot?
Yeah.
Great.
So this is the anatomical sections of the head.
Mm-hmm.
And the complete digestive system.
Okay.
And the airways.
Okay.
The half section of the head.
Mm-hmm.
The vertebral column.
Okay.
And we have the complete human skeleton.
Alright.
And we have the pelvic regions.
Okay.
And this is the model depicting our urinary system.
Okay.
And this way we have the embryonic development.
Mm-hmm.
And here we have the reproductive organs, including the genital organs.
Oh, that's great. Okay. So what is this, doctor? Like I can see this particular thing. What is this actually used for?
This is a model which is used to demonstrate CPR therapy.
Okay.
So, in case if a person due to a shock or something has briefly lost his heart function,
okay.
So there is a way, that is the CPR technique, by which the person's heart function can be brought back.
Okay, okay, alright.
So this particular model will help the students know how to provide the CPR therapy to bring back the heart function.
Okay.
So this can be done both physically as well as with the electronic device.
Okay, they just keep it on the chest.
Yeah.
Right.
So
okay,
we
that's
have
great.
Both the facility to do it both manually as well as with a device.
That's fantastic. That's another feature for all of your students.
This
you
is
see
one
that.
Special feature to demonstrate it for the medical students.
That's great. And what about this box which is available here?
These are the mortuary freezers.
Mm-hmm.
Mortuary freezers where we have the human cadavers.
Okay.
So you by using this human cadavers, we will be performing the anatomy dissections for the students.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic. That's great. It's one of the best in Zambia, which I don't think so.
Yeah,
as I told you, like none of the labs have these facilities.
So here we have the skin, the model of the skin, and we have the urinary system, and the eye. Heart and different malfunctions of heart, and here we have the models of brain, the skull, the total vertebral column, and the model depicting the thoracic cavity.
Okay.
And the other is something which we have for the skills lab.
Okay.
So the gynecology and obstetrics related models for the skills lab. And we have the dissecting kits.
Okay.
And we have the model how to go for an intravenous injection.
Okay.
A model depicting the intravenous injection.
Okay.
So these are for the skills lab.
Okay.
So these microscopes we use it for histology lab.
I think that's the overall display model. What we have, you know, seen around the lab. So, anything else apart from this, Dr. Satish, you want to explain?
So, we have in every lab a virtual lab facility.
Mm-hmm.
So, you can find the overhead projector in every single laboratory. So, a student, whatever he does physically,
okay.
or whatever he does as a practical,
okay.
to support that, we'll be having the virtual classrooms over here.
Okay.
This is another one additional feature which is offered by TAU Zambia.
That's fabulous. That's another feature. You know, you can keep adding the features about Texila one after another. Okay, I think we are done with human anatomy lab. Let's move on to chemistry and biochemistry lab, which is another laboratory which we have over here with Texila American University. All right, so we are in chemistry and biochemistry lab. let's see what facilities we have in this particular laboratory with Dr. Vetriveeran.
This is the biochemistry lab. It is a branch of science that explores chemical processes within the related to living organisms. It's a chemical, clinical chemistry. We are doing the, what are the constituents available in the blood and the plasma. So we are doing the investigations here. So what are the available investigations we are doing? They are, what are the levels of the lipids, proteins, glucose in the blood? Lab, it's a spectrophotometer. The spectrophotometer, you can assess the rays to understand the what the spectrometer used to bring the various frequencies in the fluid level. It is a quantitative and qualitative analysis of samples within the visible spectrum. We are using the blood samples here, blood samples and plasma, to identify the which frequency is available. So measure the blood components. This is a magnetic, digital magnetic stirrer, digital overhead stirrer, deep freezer. We can keep the specimens below minus 50 degrees centigrade. We keep the reagents, we keep the biochemical reagents and blood plasmas. And refrigerator, we can keep the chemicals and reagents we are using in the biochemistry lab. This is a distiller for getting the distilling water. Can heat the water and we can get the distilling of heat water. These are the fume hood. This instrument is called. It's a FHP series of fume hoods are there. And very explosive chemicals are inflammable chemicals. We can, instead of using in the benches, we can use it here. Any fumes coming with the two chemicals, already if it is there, if it is close there, the fumes will be coming up there.
Okay.
So very corrosive chemicals, very explosive chemicals and inflammable chemical, we can use it in the two jars are here.
Mm-hmm.
The chemicals, fumes are coming, we can protect ourselves and close it here, then automatically the fumes will be going outside.
Okay.
So it is a safety cabinet, safety cabinet for using the two explosive the chemicals.
So that's one of the safest features which we have at Texas American University for all the students.
And microcentrifuge, the separation of the blood cells, separation of the blood cells, and you can use it for the packed cell volume. Separation of the fluids, serum and the plasma. This is the Bunsen burner and the gas is available for the to do the abnormal constituents in the urine. It's called glucose, protein, ketone bodies, bile salts and bile pigments. So abnormal constituents of the urine can be examined here. And the various components of the blood also can be identified in the blood. With the help of the, all the instruments are there here. So, finally I want to tell about the biochemistry is a laboratory based science that brings together biology and chemistry by using chemical knowledge and techniques. Biochemistry can understand and solve the biological problems.
It was pretty informative. So, we have seen all the labs as of now. So now we are heading towards another place where we have our admin and marketing team who are sitting over here. So I think most of them are pretty busy. Let's talk to one among those. I have Ms. Belinda who is sitting here. I think she's on a call. Okay. Let's go to another person who is the star performer, Mr. Glenn. How are you, Glenn?
I'm okay, how are you?
I'm good. We are taking a video about Texala facility. So we thought, okay, we'll take you inside and just explain more about Texala.
Hello. So this is the marketing floor where we contact our students for both the on campus and the distance online programs. So this is the rest of the marketing team.
That's great. So we have seen almost all the team and few of the team members are out to other, you know, like marketing and doing presentations in different parts. So we also have a board which shows the star performers. I think it's Mercy, yeah. Star performer. So we have everyone sitting over here. We have seen the business development. We have the human resource on the left-hand side, and we also have other cabins like operations department and also the accounts. And we also have a particular boardroom for the admin department and our employees and staff over here. We have the registrar and the exam department on towards the other end of the room. So guys, as we saw the admin and the marketing floor, now we are standing in front of the registrar's office. Maybe we'll meet him sometime later. So let's go forward and meet a vice chancellor, and let's discuss with him like regarding what he feels about Texela and few points what he wants to discuss with us. Please come. This is our vice chancellor's office. His name is Dr. Ajay Poddar. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please come.
Hello, sir. Good morning. How are you?
Yeah, wonderful.
Great. So, we are taking a video
okay.
about Texela American University,
okay.
Zambia.
Okay.
So, I would like to have a discussion with you and share your points about Texela American University.
Oh, wonderful. Wonderful. In fact, welcome everybody, and I warmly welcome all the stakeholders of the university, whether they are students, teachers, faculty, and the general public for this wonderful university. In fact, this university is the brainchild of our beloved president, Mr. Saju Bhaskar and Mrs. Chitra Bhaskar. Both are the great visionary from India. They have thought that why can't African students should also have the technical expertise and excellence in the academics so that they can also compete with their counterpart across the world. So with this thought, this university has been emerged, and we already have started our operation, and we are actually, the group is actually offering 150 programs throughout the world, and we have students, around 4,000 students on the board at this moment. These students are from across 70 countries, and they are experiencing our, I can say that professionally, it's one of the best technically sound university which is running on the CRM and LMS Moodle kind of platform. So the university, actually the university is not only providing the academic excellence, but we are wanted that our student should compete the world. They should be professionally driven, value oriented, and that's what actually our professional teachers across the countries, they are inculcating the value system into these students. The students are the backbone of the university, and that's what we are taking care a lot of the students. Students can not only can take the classes from the in a very educated environment, in very educated oriented environment in this part of the world. However, they can enjoy our e-conference, e-learnings, e-library, and e-journals also. You know, the e-journals, we have 8 e-journals. So these e-journals are actually motivating the students to write down their lectures, articles, so that they can also, we facilitate them to bring out the articles and the writers into them. With saying with that, I also wanted to point out and wanted to bring into the notice of all my stakeholders, whether students or anybody, that we actually not only we are actually wanted to bring back or give back to the society also, and that's what recently we have donated 4 mortuary freezer boxes to the University of Zambia, one of the government university in Zambia. So we wanted that the students should enjoy or should have best available sources, and we have donated these boxes just for their just to enjoy their study. I welcome again everybody, and personally I feel that the students should take a very good memory from this wonderful university. They should enjoy their memory lifelong. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. That was really informative. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Charles.
So that was great information for our students and stakeholders and everyone. So that was knowledgeable information from our Vice Chancellor. So let's move on and see our other facilities for Texel American University, Zambia. Alright, so since we have seen what our Vice Chancellor spoke and everything, so we are now in the corridor of the classrooms. Over here we see the mission and vision of Texel American University. So let's just go through that. Starting off with the mission, it says that to be recognized as a leader committed to excellence in higher education, research and innovation that meets the aspirations of the global community. That's fantastic. That's a great vision. And let's go through the mission. To redefine and revolutionize international education by offering update, modern and excellent training in areas of health science, information and communication technology, management, education, applied science and all possible areas that a leader seeks to engage with Texel American University. To observe the highest standards of ethics, integrity and compassionate care for students and community at large. To make Texel American University proud of being the most sustainable university of the world through creating, disseminating and applying actionable health knowledge. That was really fantastic. That really shows, you know, how much we care about the students. And apart from that, the second foremost thing what we saw there is the footsteps what Texel has. So Texel, you know that we introduced in Guyana in South America, which is one of the English speaking country. Then we started off in United Arab Emirates. We have a campus in Fujairah, and this is the third campus in Zambia and Lusaka. Alright, so since we saw all the facilities of Texel American University Zambia, we just saw the reception. We're just coming out of the reception, walking out of the university. So just to take a rewind of what we saw there, we saw some extraordinary classrooms with awesome facilities in terms of projectors and an air-conditioned classroom with a CCTV camera to monitor the students. We also saw some high-tech labs where we have the lab materials from different parts of the world. And some facilities for the students, how Texel American University is focused on the education for our students, in terms of the teaching facilities, in terms of other facilities what we are offering. Apart from that, we also saw the library, where we have books from different parts of the world. So, etc. On towards that, we saw our Vice Chancellor, and we saw faculty, our students. I would recommend everyone to have a visit to my university and see our facilities and get to know what we are offering to our students, and then go ahead with the admission and enjoy studying at Texel American University, bringing education to life.